Hello, the internet, and welcome to our ongoing video series all about going beyond keywords with dynamic search ads and AdWords. My name's Sean Quadlin. I'm a product marketing manager here, focusing specifically on SEM best practices. So when it comes to dynamic search ads, you want to exclude traffic you don't want so that you can fine-tune your DSA campaigns. Dynamic search ads reach people as they search for things that are related to your site where you also have a relevant landing page. Searching for something related to your site doesn't always mean that a potential visitor would have any value to you, though. That's why it's important to exclude traffic from your campaigns that you don't want to capture. You can accomplish this through a handful of straightforward steps. First, exclude non-transactional parts of your site. Second, look for negative keywords. And finally, add paused keywords from other campaigns as negatives to your DSA campaigns. To start, exclude non-transactional URLs, page content, and titles from your main DSA targets. Sections like blogs, career pages, or out-of-stock or discontinued items might not provide a good return on your AdWords investment. To remove these pages from your DSA campaigns, create dynamic ad target exclusions. You can find these exclusions on the Auto Targets tab. Think about something like page content contains not available online. You could also exclude non-transactional pages like URL contains careers or FAQ. Next, look for negative keywords in the search terms report. Exactly like certain pages on your site may be relevant but not particularly valuable, certain search terms might not provide a good return on investment for you. Just like in your search campaigns, save money by excluding queries that aren't proving successful. Finally, whenever pausing or removing a keyword from another search campaign, add it as a negative to your DSA campaigns. DSA could target any gaps in coverage created by a paused keyword, even if it's a gap you don't want filled. Ensure that traffic from a paused or removed keyword doesn't migrate to your DSA campaign through diligent negative keyword additions. Think about creating something like a campaign negative keyword list in your shared library that you can then apply to all of your DSA campaigns. To recap, DSA makes reaching users easy, but it's also important to exclude traffic that you don't want your campaigns to capture. Exclude non-transactional parts of your site. Look for negative keywords, and remember to add negative keywords from other campaigns to your DSA campaigns. Thanks for watching this video, but please check out the rest of our series all about optimizing dynamic search ads.